In this screencast, we're going to look at comparing two different pieces of equipment and determining which is the better investment using an analysis known as capitalized costs. Now, the idea of capitalized cost is that you create what's known as a
Perpetuity.
and we're going to say that a
Perpetuity.
is accounting for the fact that if you were to buy something, like let's say you bought a car right now, and the other choice was to not buy a car, it's not just the cost of buying the car, but it's the cost of replacing that car down the road when it needs replaced and no longer has any value. So you're accounting for the amount that you would need now to help you pay for that later replacement cost. So in analyzing the capital cost, we're going to take into consideration the amount it costs to buy the piece of equipment, as well as this fee
Perpetuity.
that we would need to account for all our different alternatives. So capital cost, which we'll designate as K, is going to be the initial cost of the equipment, and we'll designate that as CI, plus the present value of
Perpetuity.
the which we designate P, that is there for an infinite amount of replacements made every certain amount of years. So if we think of the replacement cost, CR, right now, if I were to buy something new, it would have an initial cost. Later down the road, maybe even if it's a week later, I have to buy it again. Maybe I could sell back the one I had and have some kind of salvage value associated with it. I would subtract that out from that initial cost, and that would be my replacement cost. And this happens all the time with cell phones, cars. So if we are trying to determine how much money we need to cover the cost of the item plus the future replacement cost, we're going to say that the future cost some years later, so we'll say NY, stand for a number of years, is going to be equal to our replacement cost plus some amount of principal that we need to put down that will grow in money to have enough to replace that item. So not only are we replacing the item and we have to pay for the cost of that, but we need money to then account for the future replacement of the next item. So if we go back to our investment factors, we could say some present worth, some principal that we have now, we're going to multiply it by our compounding factor. And so this usually would be I, except that's assuming that it compounds on a yearly basis. So we're going to use our nominal rate, R, and divide it by the amount of times it's compounded on a yearly basis, and we designate that M. So then we take this to the exponent NY for number of years times the number of times it's compounded per year, M. So rearranging this, we could solve for our present value of the
Perpetuity.
as the following. So as long as we know the nominal interest rate, the amount of times it's compounded per year, the amount of years we're looking at, and the replacement cost, which again is just the initial cost minus any salvage value, we could determine what our is
Perpetuity.
going to be. We could add this then to the initial cost of the equipment, and that gives us our capitalized cost. So let's go back to our example problem and use these tools to analyze the two pieces of equipment. So here are our two pieces of equipment, reactor A and reactor B. And we have our initial cost, but we do have end-of-year maintenance, an annual cost that we need to account for. So what's common to do with the capitalized cost analysis is to discount these annual costs into present worth. And so we can use an annuity equation, which we've seen before, to take the series of annual costs and bring it to a present value. Now we're also going to do that for our overhaul cost, since that's something that's in the future that again we want to bring into a present value cost. First, we calculate the initial cost. This is going to be $25,000 that we see in the chart, plus the present value of the annuities, which is $2,000 a year times the uniform series present worth factor. So this is going to be 1.8 to the fourth for 4 years minus 1. And we divide this by 0.08, which again, that's the rate of investment, times 1.08 to the fourth. And this brings our annuities into a present value. You should get a value of 31,624. So now our capitalized cost is going to be the 31,000 624 for our initial cost, plus the second part of this equation, the replacement cost. CR is 31,624 minus our salvage value, and we're going to divide this by 1 plus R over M. Since we're using an annual compounding interest, this is just going to be 1.08 to the exponent of 4 for 4 years, and then we subtract 1. And this results in a capitalized cost for reactor A of roughly $111,000. So before I get into what that actually means, let's do the same analysis for reactor B. Our initial cost is $15,000 plus our maintenance cost of $4,000 a year plus the overhaul cost. And to bring that to a present value, we use the following compounding vector. We do this at year 3. Our initial cost of B comes out to roughly $36,000. So you can see that the initial cost is more than reactor A. So now the capitalized cost for B is going to be the $36,270 plus $36,270. Since there's no salvage value, we don't subtract anything. We divide this by 1.08 to the 6th, since it's 6-year lifespan, and we solve and get 98,072. So hopefully right away what you see is that reactor B has a lower capital cost. So what does this mean? First off, reactor B is the better investment because it has a lower capitalized cost. Now when we do a present worth analysis for comparing equipment purchases, we had to make sure everything was on the same time scale. In this case, we don't. And the reason for that is what this value means is that if we had $98,000 right now to buy reactor B, then we would subtract out the cost of buying B right at this moment. The remaining amount of money could be invested at 8%, and that would allow us to create an account that could constantly buy reactor B indefinitely every 6 years for as long as we need to, because the interest we would be making on the difference would be enough to buy that piece of equipment later down the road. Now, this does not take into consideration inflation. So we would have to have more money to perpetually buy reactor A than we would reactor B, hence why reactor B is the better investment.